A community in fear tonight, but not enough apparently to help police catch a killer, a gangbanger who shot a one-year-old baby. Folks in the Brownsville section of Brooklyn talking about the gang violence that is now a constant and the fear that now grips them. This as police look for the baby killer. Eyewitness News reporter Carolina Lead is in Brownsville with our story. Carolina.
Yeah, and Bill, there is that $24,000 reward for information leading to an arrest, but the people who live here say the culture of no snitching makes it near impossible to protect their families. Brownsville residents are tired of the constant ring of gunfire and fed up with burying innocent children.
We leave our kids and we go out to try to make a dollar, but in the end of the day, you might get a phone call on your job saying that, hey, a bullet just come through the window and it hit your child. So the neighborhood is really not safe.
The death of 16-month-old Antique Hennis has sparked widespread outrage. The infant was sitting in a stroller when he was shot and killed Sunday night. His mother, 19-year-old Sharice Miller, says she heard gunshots just minutes after handing her son to his father for a visit.
I got there and I seen the stroller and I seen my baby father jumping up and down. I couldn't go across the street. I was on the opposite side. I couldn't look at the stroller.
Bullets police say were intended for his father, Anthony Hennis, a known gang member who did not want to be on camera. Antique is the 16th child under 16 shot in New York City since May, the second to die.
They're hitting targets of people that have nothing to do with their beefs, and this has to stop in our community.
Many say they fought to make these streets safer, but now question if it's a fight they can even win.
You could only hope that you don't get caught in a crossfire. That's it. If there is any crossfires, you just don't get caught, you know?
You shouldn't have to live like that, though.
No, we don't. We shouldn't have to.
And so far, no arrests have been made in the Hennis case. Many people tonight asking me just about that. Police say his father is not yet cooperating with that investigation. Reporting live in Brownsville, I'm Carolina Lead, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.